Just like we stated a week ago, this show, this charade that Israel was putting on with this supposed evidence was all just a pretext to provide the United States a reason to pull out of the Iran nuclear deal. In that video, we stated how no new evidence was brought about, and all of this was pre-2003, and nothing new, and the entire European Union, and all the signers of the Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action knew about the information before they got themselves into the deal. So this was all a joke, and even WMD specialists and scientists around the world agreed that it was a joke, even ones that weren't aligned with Iran. So as planned, Trump comes out today and announces that the United States is pulling out of the Iran deal, stating numerous lies and once again reverting back to that information from last week by Israel as the main reason why they're pulling out of that deal. Now, as we stated many times in the past, the main reason the United States and Israel want to pull out of the deal is to pursue war with Iran. And the secondary reason is to continue to annex Palestine without any consequence. Now, the reason the Iran deal prevents that from happening is because it puts U.S. and international inspectors inside Iran that prevents Iran from creating any nuclear weapons and providing any of these states a pretext for war, because any pretext will be negated because their inspectors are there and they're the ones that are preventing that in the first place. As soon as you pull your inspectors out of there, then you can say, well, we left and now they pursued weapons again, or they're pursuing things again, which is not technically illegal. It's not illegal for them to pursue those weapons outside of the deal. Only within the deal, it made it against the agreement for them to pursue enriched uranium, which is nuclear weapon. So again, as soon as they pull out of there, they're not going to say that Iran is once again pursuing those weapons. And since their inspectors are not there, then they can claim the, oh, they did it behind our back scenario. Now, the EU and some of these other signing countries really don't want this to happen because they don't want to be a part of a world war. And Iran has agreed to stay within the deal as long as the rest of the signing countries, which include the European Union, France, Germany, Russia, China, and the like, as long as they maintain the deal, they're willing to stay inside of it. But if that weren't to happen, Iran says they're ready to pursue their nuclear weapons. And I don't disagree with that route of action because that's the only thing that prevents larger countries from pursuing a war or coming in and overthrowing their government. Because with that scenario, the same scenario with North Korea, that creates a suicide mission for anyone that really wants to take over that country. Because in this day and age, nuclear weapons are just defensive measures to prevent the overthrow of governments, because all the governments that the United States has overthrown in the past few decades has had weapons of mass destruction, but then removed them under international and U.S. pressure. The only exception being Syria, because they were backed up by Iran and Russia, that prevented a full takeover and overthrow of the Syrian government. So again, I agree with that measure if the Iran deal falls apart altogether. Now, Israel already knows this, and they're doing other countermeasures, and it appears they have another method of getting what they want. So the Israeli military is on high alert and telling their citizens in the Golan Heights, which is occupied Syrian territory, to reach bomb shelters right now, right after the news that the U.S. is pulling out. And all the news that is coming out right now in Israel is saying that there's growing concerns of Iran attacking Israel. Yes, this seems like the preparation for a false flag. Israel says mobilizing some reserve troops. So the narrative now is that Iran is wanting retribution for the U.S. pulling out of the Iran deal, and they're going to launch some kind of attack on Israel. And now that the United States is out of that deal, all bets are off that something like this happens, there will be major retribution. And just like the false claims of attacking gas research facilities in Syria after the false accusations of chemical weapons attacks, something like that will happen in Iran. They're going to attack quote-unquote facilities in Iran, or maybe even worse, maybe launch proxy war armies using the armies of Saudi Arabia, Jordan, United Arab Emirates, etc., the countries that have been recently putting together pacts with Israel that we predicted over a year ago. All of this is firing off rapidly right now, and I'm going to do a review of Trump's speech so I can just point out all the lies in that speech as well. But right now, things are ramping up, and anything could happen. Just as always, high alert right now. Watch for a false flag. Watch for any of these events unfolding. This is all happening right now. And everything really does hinge on the actions of Israel and the United States. This is what Israel wanted. So they had a game plan in place. So anything we see over the next few days, especially the next few hours, is that game plan being put forward. This is their action in play. So we finally get to see what they wanted to do, and we're going to see what happens. We're going to see if any major players try to counter that, and I'm going to keep a close eye on everything that's happening so we can come to grips with what reality is bringing us today. That's going to be all for now. If you appreciate the work we do here, please do head on down to our Patreon. We could not survive without your support, and if only 5% of you gave a dollar, just a dollar, we would be able to have $2,000 a month, which would give us enough budget to combat the mainstream media, put out nearly daily videos, and to continue to combat and fight and allow me and others to do this full time. So please consider sending your support, because again, we couldn't do it without you. Continue to keep your eyes open, and as always, this has been Tyranny Unmasked.